Once again, it's a quiet weekend in the shop, and we have a fairly unique opportunity that we're going to take right now. We have an LM2500 with its power turbine in the shop, and out in the driveway, we've got a CF66 airliner engine, which is almost the same thing except it flies, and we're going to be taking parts from both of them and mixing them together. So we're going to see how similar the two engines are. Right here we have an assembled core of an LM2500, except we haven't put the turbine in yet, so that's why the combustor outer case is the top of the stack here. But you can see the inlet, it's quite a bit smaller because there is no bypass fan. We've got the variable stators of the compressor case, the high pressure compressor because the fan is technically the low pressure compressor. And right there are the holes for the fuel nozzles. Not here, but there. These are all fuel nozzle holes. Okay, the fuel nozzle manifold has not been placed on. This is basically just an assembled core. We're going to be finishing it over the next few weeks. But take a look at the basic structure of each of the major modules, and you will see, when we take a tour of the CF6 outside, some similarities, I hope. Okay, the LM2500 is a bit unusual in industrial engines in that it has an integral power turbine, which is right here. It's a 6-stage low pressure turbine that doesn't drive a drive shaft through the center of the engine for a front fan, but has an outlet shaft that comes out here, right there. Let's see if we can take a look. Right there, it goes into that spline, and it has what's known as a hot end drive. This is the power turbine, the rear or 6-stage, and you'll see, I hope, that it looks fairly similar to the back of the LP turbine in the airliner engine. These engines are both built by GE. Actually, the LM2500 was derived from the CF6, and it shares a lot of the same parts. This part is the turbine rear frame of the LM2500. And it contains, or is actually immediately aft of, the HP turbine, which is also the core turbine because it turns all of the compressor elements which make up what's known as the core of the engine, or the high pressure system. There is the high pressure turbine without any blades. We will be building that up over the next week or so. Well, here's the CF6 airliner engine. The fan's been removed. Let's see if I can get in here and turn the fan hub right there. Sorry for the wind noise, it's a very windy day. Okay, those 20 bolt holes are what join the fan to the main drive shaft from the LP turbine, which we'll get to in a second. Okay, around here, you can see there's the compressor case. It's the HP compressor because the fan is technically the LP compressor. Looks quite similar to the 2500, doesn't it? And this array of small tubes, let me just point to one. These are the fuel nozzles right here, right there. Does that case look familiar? Okay. It's a very windy day today, so sorry about the noise. There's the turbine case, the turbine rear frame, looks kind of familiar. This is the LP turbine case. It's very similar to the power turbine cases of the LM2500, but this has 5 stages, not 6. Let's try to look around here too. Okay, this is the back of the turbine rear frame. There's the last stage of the turbine. Let's get in here and turn it for you. All right, so this is the CF6 airliner engine. And let's actually, as the last shot, we can see all the way through the engine. That's the central drive shaft from the LP turbine to the fan, right through there. On the LM2500, this shaft has an output spline right here. And the plans for this unit have changed. It's going to be an organ donor for parts to rebuild an LM2500 industrial engine. And luckily, it shares about 90% parts commonality with that engine. So with engines like the LM2500 and the CF6, that pair, and the LM1500 and J79, that pairing, it's an inexpensive way to work on the industrial engine by getting a surplus expired aircraft engine of the same pair and using the parts out of it. This is today, these days, really not the case, because nowadays industrial engines are designed to be specialized for their purpose. Aircraft engines are specialized for their purpose. There isn't any real crossing of the parts book lines. So with these two particular engines, we're lucky. We have an inexpensive source of spare parts to keep them running essentially forever. Okay, now I know a lot of you would really like to see us rebuild the CF6 and have the fan whirling away, tearing off great hunks of the atmosphere and shoving them backwards with the force of a decent-sized tugboat. A tugboat that goes 500 miles an hour. But it's just not going to happen, because a running CF6 is worthless. There's no application for it in airlines. And a running LM2500 can make a couple of million dollars over its lifetime for the owner. So I ask you, what would you like, sir? A running engine that's worthless, or a couple million dollars? So, sorry to disappoint you guys, but it's going to become an industrial gas generator and it's going to make money. Thanks for watching. See you next week.